And I call that a decision to use X for my variable. It wasn't a decision. If I had thought about it, I wouldn't have. It was simply something I did without thinking. Okay, so the functions will be sine of CT, cosine of CT, e to the ICT. The second derivative of sine of CT is what? Well, the derivative is going to be cosine of CT times C. By the chain rule, you have that factor of C. And then the derivative of the cosine of CT is negative C sine T multiplied by the C that we got from the first derivative. We get negative C squared sine of CT. And here's the first derivative, okay? Well, here's the first and second derivative for this function. Now, e to the ICT, this is a complex valued function, and this is actually the most general way we can approach a differential equation of this form to allow complex solutions, but save that for your differential equations course. I'll simply mention it, that e to the ICT has derivative, well, the coefficient of t, and the exponent here is ic, so it's going to be ic e to the ICT. And the derivative of that is going to be, well, you're going to have another ic here. So you're going to have an ic quantity squared e to the ICT. I squared is negative 1. C squared, of course, is C squared. You get negative C squared e to the ICT. So these are three functions that have second derivatives equal to negative multiples of themselves. Okay, negative constant multiples if you want to be very precise about your terminology, and that's a good idea to be that precise. Okay. In any case, now, it follows that x double prime equals negative k over mx has solutions of this form. And I've asked you to verify that sine of square root of kx over m times t is a solution to the equation. So, you know, plug that into the equation and see what you get. In class, people had no problem doing that. And also the cosine of the square root of k over m times t is a solution. And e to the I square root of k over m times t. You can verify that each of these is a solution. Well, it's fairly easy to verify. Second derivative of sine of square root of k over m times t is negative k over m times the sine of the square root of k over m times t. Second derivative of the cosine of square root of k over m times t is negative k over m times the cosine of the square root of k over m times t. And similarly with the exponential, with the imaginary argument. Okay, and then it's very clear then that x double prime, which would be this, is negative k over m times x, which would be negative k over m times this. This second derivative and this function plugged in here give you an identity. You get negative k over m times the sine of the square root of k over m t on both sides. Similarly here and here. So you should plug those in, verify for yourself that those are solutions. Now, we've asked you also to prove or show that x of t equals a times the sine of the square root of k over mt plus b times the cosine of the square root of k over m times t is also a solution. And that's quite straightforward. This is a linear combination of the sine and the cosine function. A constant multiple of the sine and a constant multiple of the cosine function added together. That's a linear combination. And that understanding and that terminology is going to be very important in your future. Okay, well, the second derivative of this function, and I'm not going to write out the details because everybody showed that they can easily write out those details, but not everybody got to the last step. Everybody had something that, had they factored out the negative k over m, would have been equal to this. But a lot of people stopped before they factored that out and didn't really show, at least to my satisfaction, although I'm sure they could have, didn't really show that this function actually satisfies this equation. However, if you factor out the negative square root of k over m, then you have negative square root of k over, I'm sorry, the negative k over m then you have negative k over m multiple of the original function. And, of course, that's what you have on this side. You have negative k over m times the original function. This is negative k over m times the original function, so we've satisfied the equation. And I've written here that this is equal to negative k over m times x of t being this, this again being identical to this. So, we've now seen one general solution to this equation. I'll add that since we have the second derivative involved, we expect to get two arbitrary integration constants when we solve the equation. And that's exactly what we've got. A and B could be any number. Okay, they could be anything. They just go through as constants. And again, what you get here is negative k over m times the original function. It doesn't matter what A and B are. So whatever A and B are, you have a solution to the original equation. This gives you the option to choose your values of A and B to fit the conditions of a given situation. And we'll see how that's very useful in analyzing simple harmonic motion.